How you doing, everybody? Let's take a quick look at The Lego Movie 2, the second part. Love the title, first of all. Directed by Mike Mitchell, written by Phil Lord and Christopher Miller, and starring Chris Pratt, Elizabeth Banks, and Will Arnett. The Lego world that we came to know and love from the first movie has been invaded by some rather childish-sounding Duplo blocks, led by their queen, Whatever Wannabe, and General Mayhem from the Sistar system. With Wildstyle and Batman leading the charge, they try to fight off these cutesy foes, but it does not go well. And within 5 years, the world of LEGO is a post-apocalyptic wasteland. Not that any of this has dampened Emmett's spirits, mind you, because he is, of course, optimism incarnate. And suddenly, Batman finds himself kidnapped and forced to partake in a wedding ceremony, and it is up to our heroes to stop the ceremony, which will bring about our Momageddon and banish everyone to the realm of storage. You've probably figured out the metaphor by now. It's not subtle. There's even a moment where one of the characters voiced by Chris Pratt actually spells out the metaphor, which honestly was kind of funny. Virtually any other movie, that would be a huge no-no, but somehow here, it works. So much to the surprise of no one, I'm sure, this was fantastic. I might even go so far as to say it was just a bit better than the first movie, which I really liked. I am amazed at how Lord and Miller are able to tell such a rich and complex story using such a simple children's toy. They've continued to do a great job creating this massive fantasy world as an analog for the lives of young children, and occasionally their man-child of a father. They are the same writers from the first LEGO movie, and also Into the Spider-Verse, so that's the level of greatness we're working here, and yeah, they're brilliant. It's very funny, it's got some great action, and the animation looks every bit as good as it did in the first movie. Even after seeing the first movie and knowing for certain that this is all computer animated, I still have trouble believing it's not stop motion. We have a lot of returning players, of course, Banks, Pratt, Arnett, and they are all clearly very comfortable with these roles. Pratt also got to voice a new character this time around, Rex Dangervest. And I cannot be the only one who thinks that sounds like a name from the Space Mutiny episode of MST3K. Rex Dangervest! Slab Bulkhead! Bob Johnson! Oh wait. And he has an army of raptors because of course. I thought Stephanie Beatrice was great as the dangerous General Mayhem, which sounds a lot like a villain from an 80s cartoon. And Tiffany Haddish as Queen Whatever Wannabe was just the perfect villain. She was awesome. And there are more cameos than you can shake a stick at. I'm not going to bother to list them all because we'll be here all day. Jason Momoa got to voice Aquaman, which was kind of cool. And Bruce Willis got to voice himself, which was hilarious. The music was once again done by Mike Mothersbaugh and... oh my god, so good. I think the highlight for me was the villain song by Queen Wannabe, where she sings about how she's totally not a villain. That was the funniest thing. And they had a pretty interesting take on Everything is Awesome, except this time around it's Everything's Not Awesome, which was oddly inspiring despite what the title would suggest. I really don't have anything bad to say about this movie. If I went back and watched it again and really tried to nitpick, maybe I could come up with something, but I loved it. This was great. I can recommend this without any hesitation. If you have not seen it, do so. And that's all I have to say about The Lego Movie 2. Till next time, take care.